The Open Amiga Sampler is a brand new 8-bit mono sound digitizer cartridge that plugs into the parallel port of a Commodore Amiga computer and samples audio at a maximum rate of 55.9 kHz. We've been developing it over the past few weeks after discovering that original sampler carts, which were widely and cheaply available up until a few years ago, have suddenly become scarce and expensive on the second-hand market. As well as making it difficult for old-school Amiga musicians to maintain our aging setups, which many of us have used continuously for almost 30 years, this also makes it harder for newcomers trying to get started with Amiga trackers. So we wanted to design an affordable, open-source alternative that's easier to build than the DIY schematics lurking on ancient BBS archives and could be modified or improved by anybody who wants to. Our other goals were to deliver sound quality at least as good as the ubiquitous Technosound Turbo Cart by New Dimensions, and ideally better. To keep the device as small as possible, front-to-back desk space is always at a premium. To focus only on the capabilities required by old-school sample trackers such as ProTracker, Octomed, NoiseTracker, and so on. And, of critical importance, to house it in an enclosure that we can put a nice Moomin sticker on. If you visit the GitHub page for the Open Amiga Sampler, you can read in more detail about our research and testing process. We used a teensy USB dev board to fake the Amiga side of things and reverse engineer some weird behaviors of vintage samplers without the risk of frying our precious Amiga hardware. We spent a lot of time faffing about with oscilloscopes and multimeters, and we read lots and lots and lots of tedious microchip data sheets. You can also learn more about the rationale behind our design decisions, such as why we added a hardware-controlled preamp, why we mixed stereo down to mono, and why we think mono is best for this sampler. Today, our PCBs were delivered, and we built the first few samplers for real. They sound great. They'll soon have their own 3D-printed cases, and then, depending on whether enough people are interested, we might even manufacture a small run to sell at affordable prices. If not, well, with these plans, you can make your own.